welcome back to my page again, you guys. I'm so sorry I've been away for some time. I just had quite a number of things to do. I've been wanting to make a lot of videos, so I have like tons and tons of topics that I've wanted to talk about. And you know what? I'm still those videos. I'll start from right from the top. Like this January, like the last week of December, I was supposed to do a video on goal setting. And I just feel like I'll still do it either way. I'm sure most people have already made their goals, but then it will be important for people who may want to adjust their goals or maybe just want to review the goals that they already made. I'm sure others didn't make, and it's not too late to make goals. So yeah, I'm going to start with the cliche that everybody says, like, when you make a goal, you need to have SMART goals. And I'm sure a lot of you have heard about that, the acronym SMART, which is just make goals that are specific, measurable, attainable, realistic, and time-bound. Everybody says that, but for you to just, some people don't understand what that is, and some people just don't really put it into practice. So I'm just going to talk about how I set my goals for this year. So first of all, the goals have to be specific, meaning it has to be specific. If it's like, I need to go to Livingstone, when do you want to go to Livingstone? Where do you want to spend a night in Livingstone? How long do you want to stay in Livingstone? That's what it means to have specific goals. Then they have to be measurable as well. Like you need to be able to tell, like, okay, I've achieved, like, how much do I need? How much have I achieved at this point? Just like saving, like you need to know how much do I need to save, and then you can measure, like, okay, it's in quarter, it's in whatever unit of measurement that you want to have. Then accountable. So it's really important to have accountability for your goals. And then there's also the goals have to be realistic, obviously. And sometimes setting goals yearly really helps you to know what's realistic and what's not realistic, because you can set maybe a goal that's so big, but then because you see your shortcomings, you see where you went wrong, it helps you to set more realistic goals next time. Then you also need to have your goals need to be time bound. So time bound is just basically about dates, like, okay, I need to do this, when do I need to do it? So that's what it's about. So the other thing now that I wanted to tell you about when I'm setting my goals, there are different areas. I didn't number them, but I think there are about six areas that I look at when I'm setting goals. And the first one is, so I'm going to just list them down. Yeah, so the first one is financial goals. You need to have financial goals. You need to know, so financial goals is basically about saving, investing. It's about tithes and offerings, fees that you need to pay, like for me, school fees. Then there's fees and stuff like that. So you can put all that in your financial goals list. And financial goals, just remember to put, don't try to put dates as well. Like, if I need to pay a membership for my association, when do I need to pay, when do I want to pay? And then just make sure they are realistic also, depending on how you earn. Yeah, then you also need to save, invest, all those things are under financial goals. Then we also have social goals. So social goals is about self-care. It's my favorite goal, actually. Each and this year has been, I think I'm doing well with my social goals, eh? Social goals is about making yourself feel good, and it's also about interacting with people. So it's about things like this year I really want to go for a facial, you know, like just to go for a facial and maybe with my friends and stuff, because I've never gone for a facial and I just want to try it out. I feel like I just do like simple home facials, but then people go out to have these things done, and I just want to see what that is about. Yeah, then it's also about networking, so that's attending conferences and stuff like that. Yeah, then the other goal is intellectual goals. This is where, this is my favorite, reading. So this year I want to read 24 books, and I'm doing well. I think I'll read double that, like maybe 48. I've just told myself, because I use public transport, so that's like a way to read, because you'll be on the bus, you'll be reading. And like, I read so much because I've just told myself every time I get on the bus, I'll maybe be on social media for some time and then start reading. Yeah, so reading is a goal that I've put because it helps your intellect. Also, other things you can put on intellectual goals are things like listening to the news, doing online courses, just learning. So basically about learning new stuff, learning how to do many stuff. That's an intellectual goal. Then we also have relationship goals. Relationship goals, for me, I believe it's basically a lot about family. Like, you know, sometimes a year might even pass and then you realize like, oh,
actually haven't visited my brother this year, or I haven't visited myself. So that's basically it on relationships. So you need to just, like, you know how the world is moving so fast these days, like, the year can just go and you haven't even seen your person you call your best friend. So you really need to take time to visit people, you know, make calls, call people. Like, you need to be deliberate about that, because sometimes, like, you really want to do something, you really care about people, but if you don't plan for it, you won't find time to show them. Then I don't know what number we are on, but the other one is the spiritual goals. So I know sometimes some people are not Christians, but you still maybe align some spirituality. So you really need to answer the spiritual goal stuff, like memory verses, reading the Bible, having devotionals, just spending time. In fact, this is the most important, to spend time alone with God and just learn more about Him. There's certain things that for you will not learn by somebody telling you, but God will speak to you, or the Word will speak to you, even as you just read stuff on your own. So for me, I feel like this is like one of the most important spiritual goals. So you need to set spiritual goals, to spend time in prayer. All those are spiritual goals. Then there's health goals. I mean, as Zambia, like I think this is one of the things that people just, like, you just go to the clinic when you're sick. No, you need to have health goals. First of all, there's working out. I work out now and I'm happy with that. I'm happy with my progress so far. It's not really for weight loss, although there's the issue of BMI and stuff. I'm still reading up on that. But then it's just important to have a lifestyle of exercising, eating vegetables, fruits, and besides that, there's going for checkups. Like, it's important to go for checkups, go to the dentist. Like, you know, I haven't been to the dentist in like forever, you guys, and I think most people I know only go to the dentist when they're going to have their tooth removed. But it's important to visit the dentist. I think the recommended one is to visit twice a year, but for me, I just put once a year, since it's like a first time. I would like to just go, you know, visit the dentist, have time to go for a checkup and just make sure everything is okay. You know, it wouldn't be nice to just, like, have a sickness or a disease that you could have avoided just by drinking water, exercising, and just having regular checkups. Yeah. Then the last one for me now, this is dependent. You can make it however you want it to be, because I belong to different organizations. I'm sure some of you also belong to different groups. You can set goals for those groups. Like, for me, I'm a Sunday school teacher. I belong to the youth group at my church. I belong to maybe some associations and groups. So you need to set goals for those as well. So I have my Sunday school class, I have groups for the kid, I have for Coopers as well. So things are simple. You haven't been attending meetings, maybe you attended things like that. So this make it 4, even 4 out of 12. It's an improvement, and if you can stick to that, then you will be well on your way to succeeding and member who actually fits the group. So how do I need to be a brand, you know, to learn, like, just like, invest in your career and set goals for that. There are so many free online courses on different things that you might want to do, so you can do those things. So this is where I'm going to end for today, but I've got like a lot of things to tell you guys about, and one of the things that we're going to be doing is we're going to be doing book reviews now. You should really look out for that. I think I'm going to bring aside to books that maybe you've never even seen, because some people read and not learn. For me, I learn from anything, any story. So I'm going to do book reviews. We're going to be talking about things like that I saw in different books that I've read. So we'll do that, book reviews and just videos. So look out, subscribe to my channel on Facebook, like my page. It's called SekaiImpact.com. YouTube is just SekaiImpact. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter. Yes, thank you. See you next time. Hi. I don't know. That's so nice. What I've done so far, you know. Okay, now. Yeah, you've said it.
Ah, oh, really?
You've said it. Oh,
no. Shit, yo. I said do. You had it. 1, 2, 3.
Basically, it's a relationship. So it's like, you really need to take time to visit people, and there goes guitar. Okay, yeah. Okay, let's start again.
Maybe I should put the